Good evening, brothers and sisters, to our Wednesday night Bible study in Isaiah.
弟兄姊妹们, 晚上好, 欢迎来到我们周三晚上的以赛亚查经。
We're coming near to the end of Isaiah, and we've seen that the book is full of prophetic treasures for us.
我们现在快来到以赛亚书的最后的章节, 我们看到这本书里充满了对我们的宝藏。
And of course, of greatest blessing is the fact that Isaiah saw a vision of the Lord throughout his prophecies.
这里面最大的一个祝福就是在借着这些意象当中，以赛亚看到了主的一个启示。意象。
It's so wonderful that we have the Old Testament to substantiate the things that happened in the Gospels and the New Testament.
当我们有旧约当中的这些的记述，对我们新约当中所发生的事情的解释会非常有帮助的。
And we know that the Holy Spirit uses the Old Testament prophecies as pictures and as foundation for the truths in the New Testament.
我们知道圣经用旧约当中的预言作为新约当中的真理和实际的一个影子。So
let's just have a word of prayer and ask that the Lord would help us understand the greatness of what he has done.
我们花一点时间让我们一同来祷告，让我们知道主所作为的是何等的伟大。
Lord, we come to you tonight and thank you so much for your precious word.
我们今天晚上来到你面前，何等感谢你宝贝的话语。
And every part, Old Testament, New Testament, it reveals Jesus and his love for us.
无论是旧约和新约，都启示了耶稣和耶稣对我们的爱。
As we enter into the study tonight, we ask that the Holy Spirit would do the work that is prophesied in Isaiah tonight.
当我们今天来查经的时候，就圣灵在这里，让我们启示的灵进入到以赛亚书中的启示。As
you study, as we study the word, would you prepare us for the coming of your kingdom?
当我们学习你的话语的时候，求你为你要来的国度来预备我们。Now
we thank you that the Holy Spirit's been given to us as our teacher.
谢谢你，圣灵被赐给我们做我们的保惠师。
And we pray that he might write Christ upon our hearts tonight.
我们祷告今天圣灵把基督写在我们的心中。And
so we commit this time to you in the precious name of Jesus our Lord.
求你把这段时间交在你的手中，是奉我主耶稣基督宝贝的名。Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, we're in Isaiah chapter 58 tonight.
今天晚上我们来查以赛亚58章。And
there are two related subjects in this chapter, the chosen fast and Shabbat.
在这章节当中有两个相关的题目，一个是神所拣选的禁食，还有安息日的安息。The
chosen fast is God's desire for the fruit that is born from fasting.
神所拣选的禁食，就是神借着禁食所要产生的果实结果。And
Shabbat, of course, is the Hebrew word for Sabbath.
Shabbat 是希伯来文的一个安息日的意思。And
for any of you who know some Jewish friends, or you've visited Israel, you know that they greet one another on Saturday with Shabbat Shalom, peace of the Sabbath.
你如果认识犹太人的朋友，或者你去过耶路撒冷，你会发现他们在周六的时候彼此问安的时候，都是说安息日的平安，安息，Shabbat Shalom.
Now we are entering into the third and final division of the prophecies from Isaiah 40 through 66.
在以赛亚40章到66章，我们到了以赛亚预言的第三个也是最后的一部分。
That simple picture there shows basically that the first 39 chapters have to do with judgment, and the last 27 chapters have to do with redemption.
大家看见我们这个三角，这个中间的图画，就告诉我们前面的39章讲述神的审判，后面的27章讲述神的救赎。Now
each one of the three sections in Isaiah 40 through 66 has 9 chapters in it.
在这一部分，从40章到66章当中有9章的里面。Now
the first section was a revelation of God himself, the I am.
这第一个启示就是神启示他是我是。
And here we see perhaps the Old Testament's high watermark of theology, that is the revelation of who God was.
我们可以看到这是旧约里最高的神学的启示，因为它是启示神所是的。
And then in the second section, which we've just finished, Isaiah 49 through 57.
第二个部分，我们第二个启示我们刚完成的，从49章到57章。
And here we see Isaiah's the deepest Old Testament Christology, that is, the revelation of Christ himself.
这里我们看到在旧约当里最深的基督论，因为它这里就是启示耶稣基督他自己。
And so these chapters were centered around the servant of the Lord, the suffering servant who died for us.
所以这些章节就专注在神的仆人，那受苦的仆人为着我们而死。
So now as we come to chapter 58, we've entered into the third and final section of the book of Isaiah.
今天我们到58章到66章，我们也讲第三个启示，也是以赛亚书最后的一部分。
So the first section dealt with the Father, the second section dealt with the Son, and now we find the Holy Spirit working to finish the work that was done at Calvary.
我们看到第一部分是讲到父，第二部分是讲到子，第三部分就是圣灵借着在十字架上的工作，把神的救赎的工作的完成。
And so in these chapters, we'll see two emphases brought to us.
在这一章节当中有两个重点。
The first will be the Holy Spirit's work to raise up a corporate testimony of servants of the Lord who are witnesses and watchmen.
第一部分就是耶和华的灵兴起了一个团体的见证，让他们做仆人和见证人和守望者。
And this we will see in chapters 58 and 59.
在这一部分我们就是在以赛亚58章到59章所看见的。
And then basically from chapter 60 through 66, we're going to see a revelation of the coming millennial kingdom.
然后从60章到66章我们就看到了要临到千年国的启示。
So tonight we see Isaiah featuring the sanctifying saving work of the Holy Spirit.
所以今天晚上我们就看到以赛亚书它特别强调圣灵分别为圣拯救的工作。
Now we praise God that we've been saved by the finished work of Jesus on Calvary.
我们感谢神我们是因着耶稣基督在十字架所成的救恩得以拯救。
But we also know that the Holy Spirit is working to perfect us and prepare us for that which is eternal.
我们现在知道圣灵为着永恒现在来完全我们，然后预备我们。
And the work of the Holy Spirit is one of convicting us of sin and then delivering us of sin.And bringing us into righteousness.
圣灵的工作就让我们知道罪，然后也拯救我们脱离罪，把我们带进公义。
Now we just finished the last section that ended with, "There is no peace for the wicked," says the Lord.
我们上一个部分最后的一句经节就是说，恶人却没有平安，主这样说。
But now in this section in Isaiah 58.We're seeing that the Lord is trying by the Spirit to bring us into true shalom, true peace.
在这一部分我们看见主借着圣灵要把我们带进真正的平安，真正的安息。
And so we see the Spirit's sanctifying work behind this section.
所以我们在这一部分看见圣灵在背后呢，分别为圣的工作。
And as you know,In the first section, it dealt with the Father. The I Am spoke about who he was, the only Savior, the only Holy One.
第一部分讲到父，讲到那位我是的，他是那唯一的圣洁的，唯一那一位真神。
So the revelation of the Father was throughout those chapters.
所以在那些章节当中就充满了对父神的启示。
Then in the second section, the Son was brought before us with continuing revelations through the servant songs.
然后在第二部分，神的主耶稣，神的儿子被带到我们面前，然后借着这些仆人之歌，不断的启示给我们。
But as is true in this present dispensation, when we come to the third section, the Holy Spirit is in the background doing his work.
然而在现今的时代，圣灵就好像在这背景当中来做着他的工作。
So we will see the working of the Lord in our lives, and then every once in a while in these chapters, the Holy Spirit is mentioned as the one doing that work.
我们看见神在我们生命当中的工作，然后在这些章节当中的时候，不一会儿的你会看到会描述圣灵好像在背后来做着这些工作。
So the Holy Spirit's doing a saving, a completing work in us.
所以圣灵在我们身上做一个拯救完全的工作。
But this involves a renewing of our minds to understand the reality of those things that we only understood outwardly.
这里就包括让我们心意更新，让我们知道好像过去我们只是在外在知道的东西。
And therefore, tonight's chapter, Isaiah 58, the Spirit redefines two Jewish ordinances.
所以在今天以赛亚58章里面，圣灵就重新定义了犹太人的两个律例。
Fasting and keeping the Sabbath.
一个就是禁食，还有一个就是真正守安息日。
Now if you ask somebody, well, what is fasting?
你问一个人说什么是禁食呢？
Oh, they would say, well, fasting is when you don't eat.
他们就告诉你禁食是不吃东西。
But that is the outwardunderstanding of fasting, but there is an inner understanding of what fasting is really all about.
但那只是对于禁食外在的定义和理解，但是在内里面还有一个对禁食真正的意义所在。
Now, if you ask somebody, what is the Sabbath? They would say to you, especially the Jews, well, Sabbath is the day we do no work, but we rest on the Sabbath.
如果你问别人什么是安息日，尤其是犹太人会告诉你安息日是那一天我们不做工作，我们在那里休息。
But now again, regarding the Sabbath, the Lord through the Holy Spirit reveals to these saints that there's something much more important about the Sabbath than just resting.
但是现在借着圣灵，神启示给我们在安息日有一些事情原本只是比我们休息还要更重加重要的事。
Now you see, these two things, Sabbath and fasting, are brought to us because they show us some principles.
在这里安息日和禁食被在这里教导给我们，因为它教导了我们一些原则。
And so it shows us the purpose, the reason for all of our spiritual pursuing.
它就告诉我们了的目的，我们所有属灵追求的原因。
Spiritual pursuing are things like Bible study and prayer.And worship, and these things, which can be seen outwardly by us as Christians, or we can understand the inner meaning of these things.
很多我们属灵的追求，无论是读经、查经、敬拜、祷告，这些好像都是有一些外在的这些行为，但是它里面有它里面属灵的原因的。
So fasting and keeping Sabbath are two outward things.Which are symbolic of all of the outward things that we do as Christians.
所以呢，禁食和安息是一个两个外边的这种基督徒的行为的表现，让我们能够学到这里面的属灵的原则。
So having introduced it that way, we see first we're going to deal with God's chosen fast.
我们这样介绍了之后呢，我们现在来先看神所拣选的禁食。
Now that's because here in chapter 58 verse 6, the Lord says, "Is this not the kind of fasting I have chosen?" And then he reveals what he means by a fast.
然后就在58章第六节，他讲到这里，我所拣选的禁食是什么样，然后他就解释了神所拣选的禁食。
Now before Isaiah can deal with fasting and Sabbath, he's got to wake the people up with a prophetic cry.
当以赛亚在告诉百姓关于真正的禁食和安息之前，他有一个预言性的呼喊。
Just as the Spirit awakes us and convicts us of things inside, so the prophet cries out to convict these Jews of their outward religious zeal.
就好像圣灵能够在我们里面把我们唤醒一样，先知在这里呐喊，也告诉了那些犹太人他们那些错位的那些宗教的热忱。
So here we have verses 1 and 2.
这里我们有第一节、第二节。
Cry aloud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet, declare to my people their transgressions, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yea, they seek me daily, and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that did righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgments, they delight to draw near to God.
第一节第二节，你要大声喊叫，不可止息，扬起声来，好像吹角，向我百姓说明他的过犯，向雅各家说明他的罪恶。他们天天寻求我，乐意明白我的道，好像行公义的民，不离弃他们神的典章，向我求问公义的判语，亲近喜悦亲近神。
Now the word of God is crying out to these Jews regarding their sins and their transgressions.
所以，神的话就向这些犹太的百姓，因着他们的罪、他们的过犯，大声的呼喊。
Now, why does the prophet need to cry out like a trumpet?
为什么先知像吹角一样向他们大声呼喊呢？
Because these believers think that they are righteous, that they are seekers of God, that they love the Lord.
因为这些信徒，他们觉得他们是公义的，他们是寻求神的，他们爱神。
How do we know we love the Lord? Because we fast. Oh, because we keep the Sabbath.
为什么我们爱神呢？因为我们禁食，因为我们也守安息日。
But obviously here the Lord is saying this, what you're doing is not right.
但是主在这里却实际说，你所做的是有问题的。
You have a lot of religious zeal.
你有很多宗教的热忱。
Look what verse 2 says. They seek me daily. They delight to know my ways. They keep my ordinances.They want me to give them righteous judgments. They want to draw near to God.
我们看第二节，这里描述他们的光景。他们天天寻求我，乐意明白我的道，好像行公义的国民，不离弃他们神的典章，向我求问公义的判语，喜悦亲近神。
But in order to understand what the prophet is saying, you have to see this key word, as if.
为了要看见先知在这里所真正要讲明的，你要看这一个词，就是好像。
Because what they are doing is outward, and it's pretense.
因为他们所做的只是外表的，装作出来的。
They are seeking me daily. They're delighting to draw near to me, as if, he says, as if they were righteous.
他们这里说，他们天天寻找我，好像行义的国民。
They're drawing near to me as if they had real devotion.
他们向我亲近，好像他们真正的敬虔。
As if they had a desire to draw near to God.
好像他们真的渴慕亲近神。
They are doing these outward things, but there's something in their heart that's not right.
他们做这些外表的行为，但是在他们内心深处却有些东西不对。
And so we find in verse 3, the Jews are asking, why have we fasted and you see it not? Why have we humbled ourselves and you have not taken knowledge of it?
所以我们看在第三节犹太人说，他们说我们禁食，你为何不看见呢？我们刻苦己心，你为何不理会呢？
Now remember, these are being written in Isaiah's latter days.When Judah is beginning to collapse spiritually under King Manasseh, and things are getting deeply into sin before the captivity.
大家知道这段时间是在以赛亚他服侍的晚期的时候，那个时候就是在马拿西做王的时候，那犹太人他们的信仰那时候就开始来低落衰落，然后都要崩细了，然后那个就是在他们被掳之前的一段时间。
So as the Babylonians are starting to come down into Judah, they're saying, we've fasted, we've prayed, humble ourselves, and you're not listening, you're not answering our prayers.
对，当巴比伦王的军队来的时候呢，他们就对神说：“说我们在这里禁食，我们谦卑自己，但是你却不理会我们，不看顾我们。”
Now, what is wrong here?
在这里什么错了呢？
Actually, in the law, there's only one reason where fasting is commanded, and that's on the Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur.
其实，在神的律法当中，只有一日。就是在赎罪日的那一天吩咐要禁食。
Now, kings and leaders could also call for a fast in historic moments where there was need for repentance or for divine intervention.
君王和领袖也在历史时期需要悔改的时候，或需要神圣的工作和工作介入的时候，需要禁食。
But the Jews had developed what they called private fasting rules for those Jews who were pious and zealous.
但是呢，犹太人的宗教里面，在被掳之后呢，他就为了那些敬虔的人定下了个私人禁食的规则。
So a man who was a carpenter in Israel or a tradesman would fast 2 days a week, Mondays and Thursdays.
所以在犹太的比如说木匠或者是工人工匠，他们就一周有两次，在周一和周四禁食两天。
You remember in Luke chapter 18, it talks about the Pharisee and the sinner praying in the temple.
大家记得在路加福音18章讲到那法利赛人和一个罪人在圣殿里祷告。
And in Luke 18:11, it says the Pharisee stood and was praying this to himself, God,I thank you that I'm not like other people, swindlers, unjust, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I pay tithes of all that I get.
18章11节，法利赛人站着自言自语的祷告说，神啊，我感谢你，我不像别人勒索、不义、奸淫，也不像这个税吏，我一个礼拜禁食两次，凡我所得的都捐上十分之一。
So there was a businessman, but on Mondays and Thursdays, as he's working, he's fasting.
所以有一个商人，比如说周一和周四在工作的时候，他在那里禁食。
You remember how Jesus said, so you'd see the Jews in the marketplace, their faces were long, and they'd be suffering and acting, so everybody could see they were fasting.
所以耶稣讲到，有人就站在公共的场合，在街上。然后他们拉长了脸，然后很痛苦的样子在那里祷告，长的祷告，然后让人知道他们在那里禁食。
Now you remember Jesus spoke about fasting, and he said there was nothing wrong with fasting when it was done in secret with a humbled heart seeking God.
对，耶稣讲到，也曾经讲过禁食，但耶稣讲到说，当一个人为了寻求神，在那里谦卑的，在私下的那在那里禁食，是讨神喜悦的。
But these people were fasting and asking why God hadn't answered their prayers and blessed them, since they were being pious and fasting.
但是这些人他们禁食，他们就在那里质问神，为什么因着他们这样的敬虔，神没有回应他们的祷告，祝福他们。
Here we see that fasting, keeping the Sabbath, may be of the heart and not just be outward.
这里我们看见了禁食和守安息日必须是从内心内在的，而不是外在的。
So you remember in Matthew chapter 6 that Jesus talked about such religious practices, but they must be connected to a spiritual reality and not just be outward forms.
我们记得主耶稣在马太福音第六章讲到说，这样宗教的操练必须是连于属灵的实际，而不是只是外面宗教的样式。
Religious things can be done with a zealous heart, yet miss their intended end.
这些宗教的事可以是因着一个人的热心去做，但是呢，他却却过了这个事情真正的目的。
We remember Paul in Romans chapter 10. He says in verse 1, Brethren, My heart's desire and prayer to God is for the Jews to be saved. For I testify about them that they have a zeal for God, but not in accordance with knowledge.
就像保罗在罗马书第十章第一节、第二节讲到，弟兄们，我心里所愿的，向神祈求的，是要叫以色列人得救。我可以证明他们向神有热心，但不是按着真知识。
So you see, our outward practices, our outward religious things need to have an inner spiritual meaning to them.
所以我们看见我们这些 外面的宗教操练都必须在里面有一个属灵的意义才是对的。
But I think we can understand the problem here.
在这里我们能明白这里的问题。
You see, the law that the Jews received was an outward law, and they were to obey that law outwardly.
犹太人们他们所接受的一个律法是一个外在的律法，所以他们很容易就做成了对于在外在的守律法的行为。
But although they saw many times in the law, according to Deuteronomy, that they should do righteousness from the heart and not just by outward,But the Jews got used to doing things outwardly, and they thought that was righteousness.
其实在神的律法当中，比如在申命记当中，神的话语告诉他们，他们是需要从内心里面来去遵行这些神的话语，而不是只是外面的行为。但是呢，他们犹太人就已经习以为常了，就把以为说遵行外面的这些行为就已经成就了公义。
So religious believers do these out self-righteous things, keeping outer forms, seeking, fasting, praying, giving alms, sacrificing, Sabbath observances.
所以我们看见这些属宗教的信徒们，他们常常保持外在形式的追求、寻求，包括禁食、祈祷、施舍、牺牲、守安息日。
But when they do these outward things, they become self-righteous, like the man there in the picture who is the Pharisee praying about how good they are, and that poor sinner behind has nothing to offer.
然而他们这样做外在的这些形式的结果就变成他们会变成自以为意，像在这个幅图画当中，这个法利赛人在这里，他是这样的，非常的自我，自以为意，然后后面那个税吏在那里。认识到自己是一个罪人。
But the Spirit has to expose their motives in twofold ways.
圣灵要从两方面来启示出他们的目的。
First, they're doing these things to gain acceptance and blessings from God.
他们的动机，第一个呢，他们做这些事是为了得到神的接纳，还有得到地上的祝福。
And they're also doing these things that they can be righteous, self-righteous, and despise, judge, and condemn others.
他们这样做的原因也是让他们可以自我为义，然后呢，他们可以去轻视或者是谴责别人。
So you can see that Isaiah 58 uses fasting and Sabbath as two catch-all examples of outward righteousness and zeal becoming sin.And by the time Jesus came, he rebuked this kind of righteousness among the Pharisees and the scribes.
所以以赛亚58章就用禁食和安息日作为例子，能够包括一切的这些人，当人用外在的公义和热心自以为义，这种变成罪恶的这些例子。在耶稣来到地上的时候，他也斥责了法利赛人和文士的这种自我为义。
There's a picture in the public square of a Pharisee praying in public, throwing his hands up in the air, and everybody just watching how wonderful this man's prayers are.
这里这幅图画就是一个法利赛人站在一个公共的集市的街口上面举起双手在那里大声的祷告，让别人都看见他是何等的一个敬虔的人。
So first,The Lord speaks about the chosen fast of the people, and then he will speak about his chosen fast.
首先，主就在这里先讲述百姓们所拣选的禁食，然后讲述他所要拣选的禁食。
First, it says in verse 3, behold, in the day of your fast, you seek your own pleasure and oppress all your workers.
我们看见第58第三节说，看哪，你们紧实的日子仍求利益，乐逼人为你们做苦工。
Now, is their fast valid if it hurts other people, or if it just serves your own ends?
如果你的禁食会伤害别人，这是一个真正的有效的禁食吗？还是会使你达到目的的吗？
You have to remember the context. Here is a man working on his job, and he's fasting on that Monday or Thursday. So what is he? He's irritable. His mind doesn't have enough food.And he gets mad and he oppresses his workers. He yells at him, behold, you fast to quarrel and to fight and to hit with wicked fists.
所以这幅图画呢，就是说好像那一个人他在周一周四进食的时候，因为他缺少食物的心情很不好，然后他就跟别人争竞，跟别人苦读，甚至打人。就在这里所记载的说，你们进食却互相争竞，以凶恶的拳头打人。
So, is fasting a good religious excuse for being irritable and testy? You say, oh, I'm serving the Lord. Oh, I'm getting up early and praying. That's why I'm so mad and short-tempered.
所以禁食是易怒和暴躁一个很好的宗教借口吗？你就可以说，哦，我这么早就起来祷告，我每天服侍神是这样的辛苦，所以呢，我就是会这现在脾气很不好，跟别人吵口。
Then verse 5 says,Is such the fast that I choose, a day for a man to humble himself? Is it to bow down his head like a rush, to spread his sackcloth and ashes under him? Will you call this a fast and a day acceptable to the Lord?
然后在下面一节讲到说，这样进食，岂是我所拣选使人刻苦己心的日子吗？岂是叫人垂头像苇子，用麻布和炉灰铺在他以下吗？你可这可称为禁食为耶和华所悦纳的日子吗？
And here again, what he's saying is, your elaborate fasting setup and rituals are meant to impress others.
那在这里神的意思就是告诉说，你们这些繁复的这些乳节的这些禁食的安排和仪式，其实要给别人留下深刻的印象。
So there he is, he bows down with his clothes torn,puts sackcloth on, puts ashes under him, lays down and says, oh, this is the fast that surely God will listen to.
他在这里做禁食的时候，就好像把那个衣服扯开，然后撕碎衣服，然后把灰放在下面，把麻布和灰铺在下面，然后说，哦，这个就是这就是那个禁食是神可以讨神喜悦的。
Here's a picture from the Middle Ages. And many Christians, in order to gain merit with God, would take whips and whip themselves in the back because they would think that this pain would make them more righteous.
这边这幅图画呢，就是在中世纪那些基督徒们，他们有的人会拿鞭子，然后抽自己的后背，他们以为这样受苦就能让他们神面前更多称为义。
God says, that's not the fast I want. Here is the fast I choose.
神说，那不是我所想要的禁食，这里才是我所拣选的禁食。
Verse 6, is not this the fast that I chose? To loose the bonds of wickedness, to undo the thongs of the yoke, and to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke.
第六节，我所拣选的禁食，不是要松开凶恶的绳，解下恶下的锁，使被欺压的得自由，折断一切的恶吗？
Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, bring the homeless poor into your house, when you see the naked to cover him, and not to hide yourself from your own flesh?
不是要把你的饼分给饥饿的人，将漂流的穷人接到你家中，见赤身的给他衣服遮体，顾虚自己的骨肉而不隐藏吗？
Now do you see the principle behind fasting?
你现在看到了禁食背后的原则了吗？
And for us, it's the principle behind our worship, behind our prayer, Bible study, our seeking, fasting, our morning devotionals.
对我们来说，这个原则也是对我们祷告，对我们读经，对我们敬拜，对我们敬拜神的这些的事情当中的原则。
All such religious exercise should have a final purpose to them.
所以这些宗教的行为在背后都有一个最终的目的。
To put it in a word, our fasting is to set us free so that we can set others free.
用话语来说，我们的禁食就是让我们首先能够得以自由，然后我们也能够让别人得以自由被释放。
Our worship, prayer, and Bible study is not just to gain more for ourselves, but to free ourselves so that we can reach out with the shalom of God to others.
所以就是说，我们的敬拜、祷告、读经是为了让我们自己能够那个己能够释放出来，然后这样的话呢，我们才能够去服侍别人。
So, as we fast, it sets us free by the humbling of the human heart until it aligns with the hearts of others around us who need help, and we help set them free who are bound in wickedness and oppression and other things.
换句话说，当我们进食的时候，就要让一个人的心谦卑，让这个一个心能够被释放，这样呢，他能够和那些被那些罪恶和外表被罪恶和外表所压制的人的心能够跟他们相连接，能够释放这些被无论是在内在或外在被压制的人，让他们也得释放。
And so that's why on Yom Kippur they do fast, and at the end of Yom Kippur, that's when they give so much money to help the poor more than any other time of the year. This is the Jewish tradition.
所以呢，就像在犹太人的传统当中，在赎罪日的那一天，他们是要禁食，而且在赎罪日那一天之后呢，他要去帮助那些穷人，他们所帮助的是远远超过在平时他们所给出去的。
So personal righteousness is fine, but it must not preclude righteous acts of human compassion, freeing the poor, breaking bondages, gathering in those who are needy.
所以个人的公义不能够排除对人类的同情这些正义的行为，比如说使穷人的从压迫当中的解脱，打破人的捆绑，聚集那些有需要的人。
As we know today, Christians are very divided.
我们知道今天基督徒他们非常的分裂。
Number one, Christian sociologists say that modern evangelical churches are marked by privatization. And privatization is when faith is seen as a personal lifestyle choice apart from social responsibility.
第一点呢，就是基督教社会学家说到，现代福音派的教会的特点就是私有化。这个私有化是指呢，当信仰被视为只是个人选择的生活方式，与他的教会与社会的责任无关。
So we have pictured all of these conferences and meetings people go to study the word and everything.
我们旁边这里有很多的照片，就是有很多人参加不同的特会来读经祷告。
But my fasting is just for me.
但这里讲到说，我的禁食只是为我自己。
But then there's the mainline churches. Now these are churches that have been around for a long time, even the Catholic Church, Anglican Church. And these churches do reach out and help people who are oppressed and people who have need, at least outwardly. But they've lost the spiritual pursuit of holiness. That's the beginning of a true chosen fast.
然后同时呢，这些主流的教会，比如说天主教，甚至公理会，他们呢强调了非常强，他们的确强调了这种禁食这种社会方面的元素，然而他们却缺少了这个禁食里面真正选择禁食所含有的对圣洁追求这种属灵的追求。
So let's see how the Lord explains this wonderful chosen fast.
所以我们看看主如何在这里解释这个奇妙的神所拣选的禁食。
A chosen fast should usher in shalom, peace.
神所拣选的禁食会带进平安。
Verse 8, Then shall your light break forth like the dawn. Your healing shall spring up speedily. Your righteousness shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard.
第八节，这样的光就必发现如早晨的光，你所得的医治要速速发明，你的公义必在你前面行，耶和华的荣光必做你的后盾。
So those who have chosen this fast, not only are free themselves, but as they minister to others, there is light over them as the glory of the Lord, gives testimony to the healing and the righteousness of their lives.
所以当这样神所拣选的禁食，当他们去他们在他们去向前服侍的时候，就好像有他的神的光见证在他们身上，他们可以服侍别人。
And then in verse 9, Then you shall call and the Lord will answer you. You shall cry and he'll say, Here I am. If you take away the yoke from your midst, the pointing of the finger, and the speaking wickedness, if you pour yourself out for the hungry and satisfy the desire of the afflicted, then shall your light rise in the darkness and your gloom be as the noonday.
第九节第十节，那时你求告耶和华必应允，你呼求他必说我在这里。你若从你中间除掉众恶和指摘人的指头并发恶言的事，你心若向饥饿的人发怜悯，使困苦的人得满足，你的光就必在黑暗中发现，你的幽暗必变如正午。
So, this kind of chosen fast, your prayers indeed will be answered, and the glory of his presence will abide with you.
在这样神所拣选的禁食当中，你的祷告的确会被应允，然后神的荣耀就会在你的身上。
And then verse 11 and 12 says, And the Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your desire in the scorched places and make your bones strong. You shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters do not fail. And your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt and shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to dwell in.
十一节十二节，耶和华也必时常引导你，在干旱之地使你心满意足，骨头强壮。你必像浇灌的园子，又像水流不绝的泉源。那些出于你的人必修造久已荒废之处，你要建立拆毁垒带的根基。你必称为补破口的和重修路径与人居住的。
There we see the Lord's guidance and blessing brings the chosen fast into a watered garden of the Holy Spirit.
这里我们看见神所拣选的禁食，有主的引领和祝福，把人带进了这种圣灵所充满的泉源之地。
Those who have practiced in this chosen fast will rebuild and repair, recover the old righteous foundations.
这些遵行神所拣选的禁食，他们要重新修建、恢复、修复神旧的公义的根基，开启古老的道路。
So what is this chosen fast?
所以到底什么是这一个神所拣选的禁食呢？
It's turning from ourselves and our own drives and seeking the Lord in such a way that he can use us in ministry abroad.
那个就是让我们从我们自己中转出来，然后寻求神，让神可以使用我们按照他的旨意，然后按照做成他所要做成的工。
We see there are many brothers who in their chosen fast brought recovery and restored the ancient ruins.
我们看到有很多的弟兄在他们的时代里，他们就行了那神所拣选的禁食， 然后他们就把那个社会当时那属灵的荒废得以恢复。
Every true recovery of the church in history has had a social dimension of ministry.
每一次教会的复兴都包括着在社会方面的执事的服事。
True recovery usually discovers some disenfranchised group without hope and faith who are brought into the kingdom.
这些真正的恢复呢都是都是发现了一些好像没有希望没有信仰的一些的人的群体。
So this reaching out in compassion is not the direction of our ministry. Our ministry is directed toward the Lord, but it's a byproduct of the humility of living faith in helping others.
这种福音在社会层面的服事呢，不是不是在福音直接的工作，但是呢这样的生活会带这样的谦卑的一个生活的副产品，就会带进了一个这样在社会层面的服事到这些人。
I guess you see these five pictures before us. Do you know who these various men are?
大家看到这里有五个人的照片，大家知道这几个人是谁吗？
The first man on the top left is A.B. Simpson, who came to New York and brought revival and healing and salvation to many.
左边第一上面第一个人就是 A.B. Simpson, 宣信弟兄，他带着福音到了纽约，把救恩把拯救恢复带给了很多的人。
When he came to New York, he came to the great, very wonderful Presbyterian church in Manhattan and preached.
他带来了很多的医治。当他来的时候，他是带了纽约最大的一个长老会。
But he was there in the 1880s, 1890s, and there were many immigrants, Germans and Jews and Irish who were in New York City.
他奶奶那段时间是在1880年到1890年的时候，在那个时候纽约城里面有很多的犹太人、爱尔兰人，很多的移民。
So when he began to preach the gospel, and many of these poor immigrants got saved, the Presbyterians didn't like it. So he left, and he started his gospel tabernacle in the middle of Manhattan.
当他大大以传讲给这些新来的新移民很贫穷的人，很多新移民都得救了。但是呢，长老教会不喜欢他这样的做，所以他就从长老教会离开，然后在纽约中城就办了那个 Gospel Tabernacle 那个教会。
And so many poor immigrants and many people were saved there through his ministry.
所以很多的穷人，很多的新移民借着他的服事都得救了。
Then the next guy in the middle there with the long beard, that's William Booth, the founder of the Salvation Army.
中间这个带着长胡子的这个人，弟兄叫 William Booth, 他就是建立拯救军这一个的弟兄。
He started by going out in the streets of London and preaching the gospel to all the poor and the homeless and the homeless children who were living in the streets of London.
他就在伦敦的街道上为那些穷人无家可归的人还有无家可归的儿童们来传福音。
And next to him on the right there, that's John Wesley.
右边的一个人就是约翰卫斯理。
He not only brought many people to Christ and was the founder of the Methodist Church.
他不但带了很多人得到基督的救恩，他也创建了卫理公会。
But he brought the gospel and social reform that changed the prisons of England, that brought many miners to salvation who were mining in the coal mines of England.
然后他就带来了很多的福音的复兴，还有社会的改变。他传了很多福音，在那英国那边很寒冷的矿场，很多的矿工都得救了。
And then down in the lower left corner, we see George Mueller, and we all know he started a great orphanage.Where thousands of homeless children came through there and grew up and were taken care of.
我们知道在左下面第一个那个弟兄就是穆勒弟兄，我们知道他办了非常大的孤儿院，有成千的上万的孤儿在他孤儿院里长大，然后很多人得救。
And the final one on the right was Count Zinzendorf in Germany.
最后那个图画在下面右边，就是新兴道夫在德国的。
And he was a lord, and he took the estate that had been given to him, and he brought in all kinds of Christian refugees who were trying to escape from death in the Catholic Church.
然后他是一个相当于爵士，然后在那边他在德国那边，他把他的产业那里向很多的逃离天主教的基督徒开放，收留他们。
And through him came the great Moravian revival and the sending out of missionaries all over the world to preach the gospel.
借着他的工作就带来穆尔维亚的大复兴，然后借着这样的工作就带来了向全世界很多的地方差派了宣教的工人。
Now what can you say about these men?
你可以讲到这些人他们有什么特别吗？
They all fasted and prayed.
他们都有禁食祷告。
But they also had fruit coming out of their lives in making a difference in their world by preaching the gospel and helping those who needed help.
他们在他们的社会当中都产生了果效，就是他们把福音传给了那些需要福音的人，然后把帮助送给了那些有需要的人。
Now he takes the second topic up just in a few verses.That is the Sabbath.
我们再用几节的经讲及到第二个题目，就是讲到这个安息日。
Now you'll see that the fast and the Sabbath are connected.
大家会看到禁食跟安息是相连的。
You see, as fasting must include the human compassion of outward righteousness as well as a personal.Desire for piety.
大家看到了，因为禁食必须包括人对于对于公义外在的这种同情肯定，以及人在里面对敬虔的渴望。
In the same way, the Sabbath, keeping Sabbath, has a fasting element. And what is that? Denying self-delighting, as one humbly delights in God.
所以呢，安息日它也有一个禁食的层面，就是拒绝为自己享乐，然后一个人呢谦卑的以神为乐。
The Sabbath is denying selfish pursuits which rob God of His day.
那安息日呢，就是说除掉了一个人对自我的追求。因着这样的自我的追求，抢夺了能够享受神的安息日。
Well, let's see what the Lord says regarding the Sabbath.
让我们听一听主是如何关于讲述安息日的。
If you turn your foot back from the Sabbath, from doing your pleasure on my holy day, and call the Sabbath a delight.And the holy day of the Lord honorable, if you honor it, not going your own way, or seeking your own pleasure, or talking idly.
你若在安息日转掉你的脚步，在我圣日不以操作为喜乐，称安息日为可喜乐的，称耶和华的圣日为可尊重的，而且尊敬这日，不办自己的私事，不随自己的私意。说自己的私话。
So the Sabbath is God's day for the Jews. That seventh day was God's day.
所以安息日是那一天是神为犹太人的那一个日子。
It was no time for self-pleasure.
是神的日子，没有时间让我们自以为乐。
And if you sought your own pleasure, you broke the Sabbath in your restlessness.
如果你要想自我享乐的话，你就破坏了安息日，你会那在那里不安。
You don't keep Sabbath unless you keep shalom, peace, and not the restlessness of constant self-pursuit.
当你不能够享受呢安息日的安息的时候，你就在那里一直不安的享受，好像自我的追求享乐。
So number two, that today Shabbat for us starts with our desire to delight in God once a week on Sunday on His day.
对，今天对我们来讲，安息日就是开始，每一周，当我们在主日的那一天，我们的心愿。我们有那样的一个要以神为乐的那一天开始。
The Sabbath honors God by fasting from going your own way and seeking your own pleasure.
所以安息日是借着禁止不走自己的路，不寻求自己的乐趣来荣耀神的。
And notice the Sabbath is a time for higher and nobler conversation rather than idle gossip and foolish talk.
而且安息日也是为了进行一个更高层面的、更尊贵的一个谈话，而不是在那里闲杂和做愚蠢的言论。
So you notice at the end of verse 13, don't talk idly on my Sabbath.
我们看在13节的最后面讲到说，在我的安息日不要说自己的私话。
So Sabbath is God's day.
所以安息日是神的日子。
And for us as Christians, the Sabbath is every day when by faith we enter into God's life.
所以对于基督徒来说，每一天当我们能够进入到神的生命当中来说，那都是安息日。
But we can't get away that we need to set aside some time for God to have His day where we delight and honor Him.
我们不能够逃过这样，就是说我们一定要设下分别出来一些时间，然后让那些时间是让神所喜悦得喜悦的。
Verse 14 says, If you'll do these things, then you shall take delight in the Lord. Then I will make you ride in the heights of the earth.I will feed you with the heritage of Jacob your father, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
14节，你就以耶华为乐，耶华要使你承驾地的高处，又以你祖雅各的产业养育你，这是耶华亲口说的。
So we enter into Sabbath rest when we delight ourselves in the Lord.
所以当我们以主为乐的时候，我们就进入了安息。
And we experience a twofold rest.
我们经历了双重的安息。
First, he has us ride the heights with him.
首先，他使我们乘驾在高处跟他同在。
We're seated in the heavenlies in the Sabbath.
我们在安息里坐在天上。
We gain a heavenly point of view, even for our work week that lays ahead.If we do the Sabbath,
如果我们有这样的安息，哪怕就是在我们工作的日子里，我们也能够得到属天的视角。
And we experience a day of heaven on earth.
我们也经历在地如在天的经历。
But the second thing is, we are fed our heritage.
第二点就是我们被喂养，供给我们应有的产业。
See in verse 14, I will feed you with the heritage of Jacob your father.
14节说，又以你祖雅各的产业养育你。
And so we experience the family riches in the body of Christ as we get together with the saints.
当我们与圣徒一同聚集在一起的时候，我们就经历了在基督里神家里的丰富。
So Sabbath is truly delighting ourselves.In the Lord.
安息日真实就是当我们以主为乐。
It's a fasting from ourselves and a delighting in the Lord.
就是向我们自己的进食，是让我们却以主为乐。
So we see here as a picture of the Holy Spirit working in us to bring us into God's chosen fast, where he frees us from within to let the out of our bellies can flow the Holy Spirit unto others as we set them free.
这里给我们看见一幅图画，就是圣灵在这里的工作，就是借着神所拣选的禁食，把我们从自己当中，让我们能够从自己当中被得拯救释放，让我们可以服侍给别人。
And then the end is for us to come into Shabbat Shalom, to the rest and the peace of the Sabbath, delighting in the Lord.
最终的目的是让我们也能够进入到安息日的安息，就是让我们能够以神为乐。
And so the Spirit is causing us to decrease more and more, that God may be all in all.
圣灵的工作就是让我们自己就是越来越多的减少，让神成为我们一切的一切。
This is indeed the work that the Holy Spirit is doing through discipline and the work of the cross.
这就是圣灵借着管教借着十字架的工作所要成就的。
When people see your life, do they see somebody whose rivers of living water are flowing?
当别人看你的生命的时候，他有没有看见活水的江河在那里涌流呢？
Do you find when people look at you, they see someone who's entered into a rest where God is first, where Jesus is Lord, and where your life is delighting in Him?
当别人看见你的生命的时候，他们有没有看见神是你的主，基督在一切之先，你以神为乐呢？
So,Even as the writer of Hebrews says, by faith, we enter into his rest.
就像希伯来书的作者说，我们靠着信心进入他的安息。
So we also find that the Holy Spirit is bringing us and preparing us for that final rest in the kingdom of the Lord when he comes and we sit there delighting in him.
我们也看见圣灵现在就做这样的工作，为着将预备我们改变我们，为着神将来要再来的国度再来的一天，我们能够在神的国度当中以神为乐。
So next week, we will look once again at the need for repentance to stay in the Sabbath as the Lord desires.
在下一周我们会再次看到一个题目就是我们因着悔改而能够停留保持在神的平安当中。
The Lord loves it when we pursue him.
神喜悦我们追求他。
But if we pursue him for our own spiritual gain, we're missing the point of our spiritual life.
如果我们的属灵追求是为了我们自己得到属灵的好处，我们就错过了我们属灵追求的目的。
Our life is to be broken bread and poured out wine for others.
我们的生命应当是被破碎的饼倒出来的酒为着别人的缘故。
May the Spirit of God teach us these precious lessons.
但愿神的灵教导我们这些宝贝的功课。
O Lord, we come to you and we thank you that you show us your more perfect way as the Spirit leads us from grace to glory.
给我们感谢你你的圣灵在把那更美好的道路指示给我们，当你领导我们从恩典进到荣耀。
Lord, forgive us when we make our religious pursuits something for our own self-gain rather than for your gain.
主啊，赦免我们，当我们有着外面宗教的追求，是我们自己为自己宗教的好处，而不是为了你的好处的时候。
Oh Lord, may all of our religious and spiritual exercises set us free to be lives poured out for others around us.
但愿我们所有属灵的宗教的追求都能够被释放出来，让我们的生命可以为着别人而生活。
And when we gather for the Sabbath, oh Lord, may we truly turn from our own desires and pleasures and delight. In
主要当我们在安息日聚集的时候，都帮助我们能够从我们以自己追求为乐的里面转离开，被释放开，让我们能够以你为乐。
We thank you for the teachings as the Holy Spirit leads us into all truth.
我们谢谢你为这些教导，圣灵带领我们进入一切的真理。
Store these things in our hearts, we pray.
把这些功课存在我们心里，我们如此祷告。
In Jesus' precious name we pray.
是奉靠耶稣宝贝的名祷告。Amen.
Amen.